This is Storyteller, and welcome back to part 2 on Pacific Drive. Unfortunately, my audio recording came up with an error and it was corrupt. So I'm very sorry, but there is no audio in this part. If you liked it, please like and subscribe. That would help out a lot. And please comment. Let's do this.
Last pinged at, back at the garage. How could that be? Oh, the car got you back somehow. Very, very interesting. I'll have to observe this further. Are you making use of my fabrication station to fix up that junker? You should while I'm still in the mood to allow it. And there's the test track behind the garage, if you need to take anything for a spin.
Thank you. you know what my favorite remnant was? The record player. You remember Francis? You play records normally, but then every now and then you hear weird voices. Like that one time it was my fifth grade lunch lady.
This again.
You know, the sooner I get this out of my system, the sooner you can have some peace and quiet.
Fine.
Hey, had a girl? Oh, boy. Hey, driver, listen. Of all the legends, of all the stories that have spawned in the zone, trust me, there are so many. Remnants? One of the best.
I'll start from the beginning. In 1964, strange objects began appearing throughout the zone. They were shabby, cast-off things that were imbued with strange properties. A broken microwave that froze food instead of warming it. A rusty can of paint that produced every color in existence. Always so out of place that people were irresistibly drawn to them.
Yeah, you know, like a mysterious car in the forest, right?
Tobias mentioned that the remnants bind themselves to people, like the cars done with you, and how that led to obsession. These obsessions always started innocently, a sudden interest in model train sets or collecting old road signs. The objects themselves would exhibit anomalous properties, but what didn't in the zone, right? That in itself wasn't cause for alarm. These fixations would only grow worse, until its victims could think of nothing else but the remnant. And they always ended with spiraling into madness and disappearing in a mad chase after something. Sorry, driver, it doesn't sound fun, but better to know what you're up against.
Could the Remnant's victims still be out there somewhere? I mean, we never heard from them again, but it doesn't mean they all died, right?
If the madness didn't kill them, then the zone did. Anyway, it's been 20 years since the last Remnant sighting. We thought they were long gone.
Until you found the car. I wonder if you're already feeling the remnant's effects, driver. Have you been
fixating on the car, maybe?
If only we knew where remnants came from. Then we'd have a place to start on how to help you. This is no typical anomaly.
Right, yeah. The anomalies we know, they're creepy, crawly, and weird. Like visible manifestations. The remnants were the only ones that wormed its way into your brain. There's something much, much more.
God, Sierra. Never wanted to think about this place ever again. Edor Town, Colossal Cappy is smack dab in the middle of where Sierra used to be. You can't miss it.
Is there a reason you're driving straight towards the largest honking anomaly in the zone?
You wanted to know if there's a speck of remnant energy in that car? This is how you do it.
You're using Cappy to amplify the remnant signal. That's insane. Sure about this?
Well, they'll be fine.
It's not fine. Look at those radiation spikes that Colossal Cappy's still giving off
after all these years. To achieve any sort of resonance, the driver's going to have to get right up against Cappy.
I get you, Francis, but Oppie's got a point. Any remnant energy lingering in the car is too weak to detect with conventional methods.
Really? You're gonna take her side?
This isn't about sides. That's a good plan.
I won't risk someone's life just so we can log another remnant sighting.
I'm not risking anyone's life. That car's clearly been protecting the newbie. Something special's going on beneath that hood. Besides, where's your sense of experimentation, Francis?
Thanks. But I'm quite content to leave killing someone out of my definition of an experiment.
Thank you.
to get closer to Cappy's core way up there. Can you find a way to higher ground? Still not close enough to Cappy.
What now?
How about, launching the car
into Cappy's core? I'm sorry. What? It's simple. The driver jumps the car into the heart of the anomaly, and if I time it right, I'll open the gateway and extract them.
And if you don't?
I've run some calculations. I think it should be fine. Anyway, it's like they always say. What's an experiment without some risk of total annihilation?
Who says that exactly?
In no way, shape, or form should we be doing this.
Well, but you know, if it's the only way, yeah, you got this kid for it.
Fried my transmission systems. Thought I lost you for a moment.
Well, it all worked out, didn't it? The gateway got you out, and it looks like the ARC device is still intact with all the data it's recorded from your drive. And my plan worked. Cappy amplified the car's signal, and it matches. Looks like Tobias and Francis found their remnant after all. Unfortunately, what they've been saying is true. The remnants drive their victims mad. Maybe that car, having sat dormant for this long, will give you a little more time. Sorry, I don't have better news for you. I'm still game to get you out of here. The faster you leave, the longer you'll have to enjoy the rest of your sanity. None of the routes you've mapped so far leads to a way out. Why don't you head back out and chart some more? You can get in touch with Tobias and Francis while you're out there. Have you found the friendly dumpster yet? It's behind the shop. If you're ever in dire need, pay it a visit. As much as the zone takes away, sometimes she also provides.
Thank you.
Are you kidding me right now? Oppie, you saw it too, didn't you? Tell me you saw it too.
Saw what?
What do you mean, what? The hallucinations! Like the ones from 1961!
It happened again, just a quick blip, like blinking your... Wait, you didn't see it?
I was in a total blackout. Colossal Cappy fried my systems.
Right, because sending the driver headfirst into Cappy didn't work out like you said it would. Big surprise.
Oh, spare me, Francis. The driver's alive and your remnants verified. Isn't that all you wanted? Now, why are you two yapping about the mass hallucination?
When Cappy amplified the remnant's signal,
it triggered another hallucination event. But it only lasted 3 seconds this time. And not only that, we picked up that its source was northwest of us. Specifically...
Yeah, somewhere in the deep zone.
That's impossible. It's been... 40 years. Hallucination wave that triggered. We picked up its waveform, and turns out it's equal and opposite to the remnant's waveform. They're paired signals. It means they're related. And what's more, if we bring that car to whatever this mass hallucination source is, we have a chance of nullifying the remnant and breaking its bond with the driver. A simple destructive interference.
This is insane! After all this time, we find a remnant,
lead on the mass hallucinations of 61, and a possible way to free the driver? Pinch me, Francis, because this is the best thing that's happened in decades, just when things were getting dull.
The remnants. It was a key to the mass hallucination. This whole time.
Yes, and you nearly destroyed it.
I need to go.
This is huge, Francis! We have so much work to do!
I know. I've already pulled every report on the mass hallucination event. Driver, listen, you stay safe out there. We'll report back to you once we've gone through all of this data. There's a lot of it. And be careful. Oppie's not in her right mind, okay? So, watch yourself.
I owe you an apology. I screwed up. I nearly got you killed.
The things I used to calculate as easily as turning a screwdriver, they're foggy now. The numbers don't work themselves out like they used to. I haven't been myself for a long time, but I haven't needed to be. It's been me and this cursed place I created and nothing else for decades. But now, knowing that whatever caused the mass hallucination is still out there, I need to know what it is and why the remnants are connected to it. Francis was right about the remnant and the mass hallucination's paired signals. If we can get them together, maybe they'll cancel each other out and you'll be free. It's a shaky theory at best, but it's the only lead we've got for now. You can do nothing and twiddle your thumbs until that remnant drives you mad. Or, if you're willing to work with me, I'll give you the best chance to survive this thing. Think it through. And fix up your car while you're doing it. You'll need to for whatever you decide from here. Ready to do this with me? Here's a spot of good news. We aren't completely helpless when it comes to the instability. Back when the zone was active, we built ways to get where we needed to go. I need you to head back towards Serum. But don't worry, I won't make you jump into Cappy again. When you're feeling up for it, take the route back to Serum. I'll tell you what's next once you're there. The mass hallucination.